Oh man, it's snoring, it's raining, pouring. The old man is snoring. That's right. Doop 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 boop doop boop 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 doop. Check it out, you can extinguish. Extinguish these things now. And of course it remembers. What's up, Zilton and Mightiness? Pedro 1, Snake Spear. Oh, I just noticed you can't hit these. If they're already at 0 hit points. Well, I'll work on that later. Jonah19, what's up, y'alls? So yeah, these light pillars recharge now. You can hit them a bunch, and then they recharge all the way back to their normal health, unless you hit them enough that you extinguish them. Yeah, so that is one unfortunate thing. You can't. Can't hit the pillars after that. Am I offline? What? I'm online. Okay, so I'll keep working on that later. What I want to work on today is making the bosses more fun. Yesterday's work with the Snake Spear. I got the Snake Spear, so he's pretty much a passable enemy. But I'm really not happy with the Snake Spear yet, and it really made me realize how unhappy I am with the other bosses. So all the bosses need a lot of work. Yeah, so the Snake Spear, he's a passable boss now. He just comes up and down. You can hit him only when he's, like, right here. You know? So, yeah, you can play him and you can fight him right now, but I think the one thing that would make the Snake Spear a lot funner would be if you didn't know where he was coming up. And that way you could be hit by him if he's coming up through the ground. And if he were in an environment like this with these level tiles and stuff, and maybe he could break through the tiles or whatever, you still would have an idea of where he's coming up. Really, the only solution to make him where you really don't know where he's going to come up from is either to make the ground sand, so he's coming up through some, like, sandy substance, or to make the ground water, and you wouldn't know whether he's coming up through the water either. So, that's what I'm going to eventually do with this guy, but I'm going to take a break from working on the Snake Spear today and actually work on the regular first boss again. Yes, he's going to snake around. Yeah, he's going to snake around, too. That's just, like I said, I'm gonna work on him later. Because I want to focus on the first bosses already. I need to take a break from the Snake Spear. So I'm going to work on the dropped boss and make him more fun. Because right now, the dropped boss is still not that fun. He's just a regular guy. So what he needs is to be more fun. I want to make him drop stuff from the ceiling. So when he yells, some rocks fall from the ceiling and you can get hit by the rocks. All right. The world has this little debug thing I could turn on. It'll show me where everything is. You know what would have been cool? Two snakes. Well, maybe I'll do that eventually. Once I turn it into sand. What's up, nerdy? Welcome to the stream, man. Howdy, howdy. Okay. So let's see where this guy is going to be at. Drop boss. What? Oh, I need verbosity 3. You haven't got the ghost sword yet? Oh. It's supposed to be one of the first items. Did you start playing it before the last update though? Things change. If your current world save you started before the last update, then it's possible that the ghost sword moved. It's a new world? Oh, okay. Huh. It really should. It should put the ghost sword sooner. I mean, maybe I didn't code that right, but it's. I thought I had some code in there which made. I don't know. The drop boss? The drop boss? He already has a name. Okay, where's he at? Oh, there we go. 171. All right. Oh, you already had this position too. Oh, because of the Verloc issue. Oh, this guy's freaking out. So, what was the problem again with the Verloc? Oh, because he's in the sandy dungeon. Oh, that's right. Yeah. Okay, I'll get that fixed. This needs to be a higher priority. It probably is in that dungeon, I bet you anything. This needs to be a higher priority item over here. So in this one too, this one's orange. This is code orange. Oh my god. And this one is at least code yellow. No, this is code orange. Almost breaking. And this one too. What's up, Arcane? What's going on today? I'm working on the drop boss. I'm taking a break from the snake spear boss, and I'm working on the drop boss today. What I want him to do is to drop rocks from the ceiling whenever he yells. And so that I want him to yell a bunch. And something went really weird. He's just all of a sudden crazy. I mean, since last night, I must have changed something and broke this guy. Just doesn't want to. What is he doing? Stuck. He's like stuck a bajillion times. Well, if there's any buffering issues or video issues today, you'll be able to see it on YouTube later. Taunt, choose. Okay, so he chose. But now he just keeps. Choose. Jeez, I didn't think I'd have to start debugging right away. What did I break? What did I break? What if I hit him? Oh, there. Okay, if I get near him, he starts doing this. But then he goes, choose, choose, choose. Choose, stuck, choose, stuck. What is he doing? If target none, target nearest friend. There's got to be something which removes his target then. Oh, here. Hammer time, target none. Oh, Jonah, yes, good suggestion. It could be Z collision related. You were totally paying attention yesterday. Man, thank you, man. That could be it. That could be. Right? Because it could be something to do with nearest or near. Making bosses more fun sounds fun. Nice. See, I know he's very cat-like. We're currently. All right, I'm going to try taking off his target none really quick. It could be collision related, but I can't see how it would, but that's usually how bugs are. He even aimed the wrong way. He's like perfectly aiming wrong. Oh, there he aimed correctly. Oh, maybe he's just aiming to the right only. No. God. Target none, target nearest. Let's try target hero. Didn't help. Whoa. I'm baffled. What's up, Red Sands? It appears that possibly he's getting stuck like crazy a lot. So if I turn off that. Well, flying targets are flies. How can he get stuck? I don't know. I mean, you're like, check the collisions. So he stops moving when he does his attack. What's the problem? Everything is the problem right now. He's overnight he's turned into the dumbest enemy ever, and it's what? Man, this is disheartening. I wanted to get creative and work on this guy and have him ro drop rocks from the ceiling and stuff. And now I'm finding myself in a very confusing state. Like, what the hell happened to this guy? Okay. Durnan's obviously part of his whole shtick. He's trying to escape. Free the boss. Free him from his chains. Okay, maybe he needs a proper seek sequence. If target any. If Rand to their target, face target. Free beer. He's just drunk. He's just drunk. That's what it's gotta be. Okay. Start by simplifying, I guess. I'm gonna turn off everything but the foes. So there's gonna be no flies on the screen. Nothing else with AI except for Jib and this guy. So that I can start setting some breakpoints in the code and figure out what's wrong with his behavior. See, this is the weird part. He starts seeking and going crazy. It's almost like he's seeking himself. Right, I'm turning off hurt. It's hammer time. Hell, we'll even turn off choose. Set him. So he targets the nearest friend right when he taunts. Now all he's got is taunt and seek. So all seek does is set the direction towards the target. Really, we shouldn't even need face target. But still, he freaks out. What What the fuck? All right. Okay, we only have one AI that's got this command running right now. Dir target. What was I changing yesterday? I don't know. AI system, let's figure this out. Behavior target. Not targeting the line. Not any of these ifs. This is not an if. Not an if dir. Here it is. Behavior target. Target mask. Wait a second. Oh yeah, you can set the target if num values is greater than one and stir val. Huh. I don't know. No, this is target. Oh. Yeah. Oh wow, I should check this out though. Shit. This could be a big part of it right there. Let's see. Yeah, let's figure this out. Start with just the target. What's he targeting? He's like a dog chasing his tail. He is. It's like, yeah. What's this? Oh, my tail. Yeah, let's keep chasing it. All right. So the command that it's running right now should be target nearest friend. And what do we got for values? Yeah, stirval 1 is friend. Subtype is 125, which should be nearest. So if num values is greater than 1 and stirval 1 size, so this should do this. It should set its target mask. This would be a really important part of it all right here. So we're going to parse mask stirval 1. Parse flags. First word. Friend. Die. So I did change this yesterday, but this should not be negating this word. Negate should be false. Okay, it is. If negate, no. Negate, no. Okay, we're returning value 32. We got 32. So the target mask is 32. We should be just friend. Can confirm that. Filter friend, 5. One shifted up 5 is 32, right? Sounds about right. Good enough. Okay, on to where it's setting its target. Rand? No. Hero? No. Nearest? Yes. Potential. Get eids? Oh! Oh, I did change this. That's right. I was doing a bunch of collision system optimizations yesterday. And I changed get eids. This could be the problem right here. Let's step into this. Get eids. IDO mask. Yeah, that's all looking good. Is match if O collision category and mask. It should be equals mask. And O eid is not equal to ID. Yeah. Then push it back. All right, we should be able to get these fine. What does this return? Potential. This potential array should have... Oh, good. We have two friends. Yes, that should be rock. Yep, one and two. Rock and Jib. Both those are... That's one and that's two. So, okay, so that worked. That's fine. I did not break that function yesterday. Closest one should be either me or Jib. I'm not sure. Turned out to be rock. All right, set the target. Return true. Okay, that all worked. That all worked flawlessly. Nothing has gone wrong there. So here's the next part. Why does it keep shaking when it sets dir target? So going back to AI system. Setting the direction. Set a breakpoint there. This is where he's going crazy. We're about to find it. We're about to find the bug. What's the bug? What is it? What's the bug? Oh, I'm so curious. All right, there he seeks. He's like, I'm going to set my direction. So I'm heading towards the player. But it doesn't work every... Okay, first of all, we should need to confirm that he still has his target. So EAI target one. Very good. Okay. Still got the right target. Now the direction we're setting is not rand. It's target. See, this is a two-dimensional vector. But that's okay. This is a two-dimensional direction. So what does this vector turn out to be? Negative 66, 0 on the X. Seems about right. We're exactly lined up on the X. Compass direction from that vector should be south, which would be EAI dir is just 0. Yeah, direction south. Okay, there he goes. He only said, okay, he said his direction once. And wiggled around the whole time. That was so weird. And his direction is still south. He should have been heading directly south that whole time. But instead, he wiggled. Stupid wiggler. Yeah, that's what I'm about to check out right now, the actual code that moves him around. I was wondering if it might have had to do something with that, but no. Okay, tick. See, what happens is once an AI has a set of direction, it goes and it sets its buttons based on its direction. Here it is. AI system apply input. And then the next frame, the input that's applied becomes So, if his direction is not none, we'll set a breakpoint here. All right, so there. He should get a direction. He should apply his input based on that direction. The movement system should move him based on that input. Something's randomly going on where he just wiggles. Alright, he finally has a direction. His direction should be south. Definitely doesn't have vector movement. That's good. Okay, let's see what happens when it adjusts his direction. Yeah, so it allows all eight directions. This direction should still be south. And then it just sets the button down. All these have, yeah, I haven't changed any of this code recently. This is All right, let's find out what's actually getting applied now. Now that he's applied that input, we'll set another breakpoint where he uses his movement. What's up, Azaris? This boss, this drop boss, all of a sudden, he's just wiggling around. He's not even moving. Pisses me off. Okay. So, okay, here we are. Start movement. Should not be using AI vector. That's false. Okay. He should be alive. He's not attacking. Shouldn't be move locked. Okay, good. We're going to call get compass direction from his movement. It should have only set south or down. So what do we got here? Up is false. Down is false. There's the problem. He didn't even have his down button. What? So this is just going to return... Wait. Nothing in his button time. Wait. What entity is this? Should be the boss. It could be the player. Oh, this is the player. Oops. Okay. Next one. That's Jib. This should be the boss. Yeah, that's the boss. Okay. Not using AI vector, right? False. Okay. Okay, compass direction. This should be south. Yes, down is true. Everything else is false. That's great. Oh, that's the check diagonal. This is where it checks the latest button and all that. Just exit this method. What do we get for return value? Doesn't give me the return value. Okay, entity. Move compass direction south. That's right. If he's panicked, he's panicked. My God. He's panicked. All right, we found it. We found it. This is obvious now why he's wiggling around, because he's panicked. That's what the panic is supposed to do. So obviously something happened when it parsed his movement flags to give him move panic. Why? How did he get move panic? That's not right. Oh my God, look at his flags too. They're gigantic weird. Oh, that is what I did change it to be 64-bit integers recently. Hello, Merienda. What's up? What's up, Hardboiled? Okay, so let's see this as a binary value. Yeah, look at that. Everything. Oh. Those flags do look like they were not masked. Oh my God. Okay. Well, okay, this the source of figuring all this out. What am I doing today? No, I'm taking a break with the snake boss. The snake boss is not very fun yet. He needs to kind of like come out of the floor or something and just to like surprise the player. It'd be a lot more fun if he came out of the sand. So he's gonna be a sand boss, I'm thinking. And I'm gonna work on him when I get to more of the sandy areas. So today I'm working on the drop boss to make him more fun. Right now the drop boss just hits you with his hammer and all that. I want him to be more interesting, to be more fun. And as you get up into higher levels, like level 8, 9, and all that, he gets harder. And so I want rocks to fall from the ceiling. And before, I've been working on a bug the whole time before I even can do that. So yeah, there's a snake boss, Azarus. He's a big old snake dude. He travels in a snake-like chain. Okay, so flags are getting parsed wrong. What the hell? Okay. Don't need that breakpoint. Where is it parse? It's movement flags. Move component, of course. Kid parse flags. Child get flags mask, blah blah blah. Okay, so the drop boss. You should have move. Oh! Oh my God! Wow. Well, there's the problem. Somehow I had this little squiggly character in here. And I didn't know it. Shit. Man, I need to check where if I did this in anywhere else. Grep star.txt. Is it the files first or the thing you're looking for? No. Grep squiggly star.txt. Hey, that's not working. Oh, grep R. No, grep R. No. Quote it. There it is. Okay, so we got Snakespear, Verloc, Wait, what's up with, why didn't we find the drop boss? See that? Drop boss did not come up. Why does it? Oh, you suck. You suck. Oh, that's because it's bosses. Grep R. Jesus. Okay, I'm just gonna mate it. There. Okay, now I'm showing everywhere else that has all these squigglies so I can make sure nobody else had this curious problem. So this guy should have pathfind, but no squiggly. Did I make a boo-boo? Yes, I did. Tildy, right, right. A Bobo. That guy? Oh, from this is from Double Dragon? Yeah. Snakespear properly has a Tildy. That's supposed to be there. Those are going to work. Yes. Wait a minute. I don't know. I might have broken that too. Let's see if flags. It's going to be an AI system. Behavior flags. If flags are nege, blah, blah. Parse flags word. Oh, right. Okay, this already does its own negation, but it really doesn't need to. So, oh gosh, I'm just gonna set some white space around this, so I remember to check this later after the stream because I'm already tired of working on this bug. Foes, okay, all these should be right. Shit. I don't know if it changed that too. Set flags. Yay, Zilton, cool man. Scottish pizza, what's up, man? How you doing, Scottish pizza? No, I don't know. Butfu's here. He's just not here today. I don't know what he's up to. But Buffu is alive. Don't believe the lie. He's alive. All right. World. Make sure I didn't break this too. Set flags. Shoot. Oh, this needs to be like that. Yeah, this one's okay. Whew, man, this is one little thing broke a lot of other things. Yeah, that's not even needed. Okay. There, it was one single freaking character. What have I changed so far? Let's unchange everything. Check out data foes, or I mean data bosses, drop boss. Now go back to the drop boss. Take off this tilde. Freaking Tildy. Damn, I was pissed off at that Tildy. I'm good, Pizza. How you been, Pizza? How's your album going? You should make a bot called Raccoon Food. You love naming things, don't you, Zilton? Yay, look at this. Finally, he's working right. Oh, man. It's good to have you back, Drops Boss. Functioning normally. Single character fix. Can't believe it. Alright. Let's turn the draw debug back to zero. Okay. So, okay, everybody who's watching the stream, pretend like the stream just started. Because this is where I wanted to start today. Right here. I want him, right when he does that, when he taunts and he throws his hammer up in the air, he yells, I want some rocks to fall from the ceiling. Let's freaking draw a rock. Right now. Metal Gear Solid 5? I haven't played 5 yet. You got some new song ideas? Cool. All right, so I'm going to copy this pillar. Make a rock. Let's make it fall from the ceiling. Yeah. Okay, good enough for a start. So yeah, this thing will fall from the ceiling, break open to a bunch of pieces. For now though, just starting it with single frame is all you really need. You're back with cereal, yeah! Oh, some music. I can't play actual music, sorry about that. If I play music, YouTube will flag my videos. Sucks, but yeah, if my videos are flagged, then people can't watch them. So I have to do silence, man. Sorry about that. That's why I try and talk all the time. As often as possible. I don't normally talk all the time. I'm a programmer, you know what I mean? It's difficult for me to actually talk and do what I do. I just forgot what I was doing. What was I doing? I don't remember. Oh, well. Well, I'll just save this as something. Rock Zero. Sounds like a good enough name. Export this. Rock 00. Make sure this gets packed. I forgot what I was doing because I talked. Exactly. Talking does that. If you're not talking about what you're doing, you forget what you're doing. All right, we're going to need a rock projectile type thing. I guess they'll probably spawn. They'll like spawn a bunch of projectiles. I guess we'll start with. I mean, this is something that falls from the ceiling. Is shit. This is gonna be different than a lot of other enemies. I guess what would it be like? Lightning, sort of. No. It moves. It moves, so it needs to be like a either dart. I guess dart would be a good thing to start with. Let's copy dart to rock. Open up rock.txt. Render flash, yes. Shadow, yeah. Collision, shot foe. Don't mask with anything. It's about the right size. Damage a half. Move. Don't mask with anything. Move about that fast. Input allow. Just south. I guess we'll do 8. Just in case. And then this is going to be rock 0. All right. So if it's got all these remove timers and stuff, this might do. We'll see. So we'll make the drop boss drop a rock. So when he's taunting, let's go spawn rock at like 0. Or how about negative 50, 0. This is going to just spawn a single rock whenever he taunts. All right, pizza. Good night, man. Sleep tight. Whoa, BC Warrior train. Okay, I hit the rock. That was good. What happened with this rock? It just magically appeared. Yeah, it just magically appears. Okay, I mean, it works. I guess next we'll get him to fall from the sky. Oh, the rock should have a color though. Color type rock. That's better. Now it's colored greenish. Couldn't do it. It was a dead train anyway. Whoa, look at that cat. I've never seen that emote. Okay. Let's start by making spawning three-dimensional. Oh man, this can just you can be you can create these straight from there. Don't even need to do any of that. What would be new with big drops? What would be new? What is going to be new is rocks falling from the ceiling. Who's ringing the doorbell? Pizza man? Pizza Man to the rescue! I know I want pizza too, but that guy was definitely not Pizza Man. It was just the UPS guy. Does he just randomly show? I wish the Pizza Man did just randomly show up. Is the pizza Scottish? No. No. Not only was it not the Pizza Man, but he wasn't Scottish. I wish, I wish. Okay, we should have 3D spawning. So I can just go something like this now, put this up to 160, and it should fall. Rocket Bunny! What's up, Rocket Bunny? Heyo! Hey, it worked! You see that? That rock totally fell from the sky. I saw it. Let's make this happen a lot now. Spawn a rock like all the time. What's this one? It's not loud. Nice, nice. Right? They should send pizzas. That would totally. Yeah. What's up, salad dogs? Okay, he's dropping rocks like crazy. And if I get near him, I. Cool. Oh, do you see that? When it dropped on the, on here, it actually seems to look pretty cool. Okay. So the next thing they need to start, they need to explode when they hit the ground. Yeah, there'll be some. It's gonna make it. No, he's gonna have a taunt. So he's gonna lift his hammer up in the air again and go raw, and then the rocks fall from the ceiling. So, but before I do that, I want to make it so they explode when they hit the ground. Look at that. His hammer hit that and. Okay, we can do this. This is possible. So the rock, when it should have a. I think we need to take out that if target none. So it removes itself right when it hits the ground. If stuck. No, that might actually do that right away. No, it didn't do it at all. Huh. If collision remove. Actually, we could do a position. If position Z is less than 10, remove. So there, once it hits the ground, I think it should be bigger, huh? Nice. How many frames in the hammer attack? I don't know. 10-ish? 4.5? 1? 1.5? See, now they're just disappearing like crazy fast. So what if this thing spawns a small explosion? High frames. Hey, there, it worked. Yeah, this is working pretty good. Your first game in Unity? Nice, man. Way to go, Rocket Bunny. Oh, what's it like? You got any screenshots? This scripting you're talking about? Okay, so we don't need this remove target. We don't need remove stuck. We just want it to remove once it hits the ground. And I guess if it has a timer end, it should also remove. And it does need to do it. It does need to do an animation too. So spawn. We'll go spawn small explosion and then set it a short timer. Yeah, I think that'll work. But wait, this is gonna call itself over and over and over again It needs to move itself into some kind of state where. Oh, I guess we could just go delay as well as setting a timer, and then it won't run itself anymore. So that'll only spawn one explosion, and then it should give itself a good half second to run any kind of animations or whatever once it's done. Yeah, right. Once the scripting is all. Nice, Zilton. Nice. They're pure sodium metal. Boom. Is it the delay? Why isn't it removing? They're black holes. Oh, see, that's spawning like a bajillion of them now. Okay, so that was working. I don't get it. I don't get it. The poison bubble also works like this. Poison bubble. The poison bubble has if timer end remove. If collision, oh. This is exactly the same code, but this guy's not removing itself. Oh, that would make sense because I set that delay. So I guess we could either set target or we could set. Or just check the timer. If timer is greater, if timer is less than zero. No, it gets a timer at the beginning. It has like a lifetime. I think it does. Well, yeah, this might break it. You see my idea, art idea for the rocks above? Oh, sorry, man. Maybe make a beam of light from where the rock falls. Like it opens up from the ceiling. Maybe. Oh, yeah, that worked that time. Sweet. It's magically working! Yay! Timer's less than zero. Position Z is less than one. Spawn small explosion. Set the timer for a half second and animate its release. So let's make this thing look like a. Let's do an animation where it blows up. Boom! And then I guess it could just. It could have activate. Could have activate 0 HP. Or we could just call remove. Like remove AI component. Oh, it doesn't even have any hit points. I guess if I called remove AI, I guess that would. Yeah, that might be the thing to do here. Let's see if we can do that. Is it a virus like Pedro's games? Zilton, when Rock wears a top hat, does every other boss wear a top hat? I don't know. Yes, a buffering every day. I'm buffering on purpose, too. I'm totally doing it on purpose. Here we go. Collision health. Let's get move, collision health. Let's do AI. So that the AI component can be removed. There we go. Okay, we got an AI word. So now if I go remove AI, there, we should be able to leave the rock intact or whatever its last frame was, it should stay there. And this doesn't need a shadow, but I guess it does need a reflection. Okay, now in the AI system, we'll make it so when we call behavior remove, we got some other kinds of components we need to be able to remove too. We got remove the move. Health. And AI. In terms of music, why don't you play Songbringer music during Songbringer streams? I mean, I could, but I would get so tired of it myself. There's not enough of it yet. But I do play it when there's music going on in the game. Oh, that's what I was trying to remember that other time. I forgot that I had music off. So there you go. Here's Zilton. Check it out. There's some music for a second. There should be a boss with a top hat where he and Rock fight to see which top hat is superior. Of course, he will have an evil mustache and a monocle. Yes, he would like it. Okay, yeah. So now we got some rocks that are staying on the screen, but they shouldn't hurt me. No, they are. Yeah, this thing itself should never really hurt you. And they're flashing too long. Okay, so flash, this thing falls out of the sky pretty fast, so like it should flash only for maybe that long, 7/10 of a second. It doesn't need a category shot foe. In fact, it doesn't need any kind of category or collision. Yeah, it doesn't need any of that. It doesn't need a collision at all. There, so now when I walk over it, I won't be able to be hit by it. And next we'll do an animation where it explodes into pieces and then the pieces can stay on the ground. So now, yeah, I can walk over these, but if I get hit by one straight up, it'll do that explosion. Let's see if I can get hit in the head with one. Opposite of me. That makes sense. Okay, so the drop boss, it's because I did negative 50 or whatever for all these positions. Let's set all these to 50 real quick. I want to get hit in the head with one of these rocks. Yeah, totally. They hit me in the head. That's good. All right. I have a would you rather question. Would you rather be a girl with a penis, but nobody knows? Or would you rather be a guy without a penis, but everyone knows? Man, what a choice. Hell, I'd be a girl with a penis. That's pretty awesome. You got multiple ways to be pleasured? Heck yeah. Oh, so that some of them aren't exploding? Is that what it is? Whatever. Let's get them to I'm gonna animate them so they fall apart next. Rock zero. All right. Create a video timeline. Set that to 0.1 seconds. Yeah, this is going to be a simple animation. Just have it, boom, explode to pieces. It's maybe a little too small, actually. Let's make this width 64, height 48. Whoops. All right, that's, yeah, that's a little too tall. Zilton would go for girl too. Next frame. La 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 la. Next frame. Ha ha ha. I'm Pee Wee Herman. Falling Cubes, cool. Rocket Bunny, I am proud of you, man. I haven't even seen your game, but I'm proud of you, dude. Way to go putting your game together, getting on all those platforms and stuff. I'm sure you're learning a lot. Rocket Bunny is barely starting making video games. He's already moved into using Unity. He was using Game Maker. Personally, I think they're both great. Game Maker and Unity. Okay, we'll go, yeah, frame one. This thing where it starts exploding a bit. Let's give me the lasso tool. Set this into chunks. Could not use the move tool because the target layer is hidden. I am a robotic program that cannot help you much. All right, we'll split it into four pieces. All right, now each one of these pieces I'm going to redraw so that it looks 3D. You got to make sound effects when you're drawing stuff. It really helps. Yeah, that looks good. That's a good piece right there. Yeah, you're welcome, Rocket Bunny. Turn it into an MMO. Yeah, I'm watching on the iPad too. I would totally click on it. But I'm iPadded right now. Okay, we make this look like it's three-dimensional. Ooh, wait, I got an idea. The rock needs a sound. Duh. Sound explode. That one totally did not explode. You're totally right, Azenris. Maybe that Z was a little too low. Wizard in the Dark is your favorite musical? Going to England? Cool, man. So let's get the rest of these pieces. There we go. Now we got four pieces. This part, though. Yeah, I'm gonna turn that into. Yeah, no more highlights like that. I don't need those. Oh, this needs a little shadow. Better. Okay, now that we have four distinct pieces, I'm gonna save this as pieces. And then each time I do another layer, I can. That's right. Mustaches and beards got it down. Mm-hmm. No one to ban you. It's so true, right? Hey, this is a really nice thing. The whole chat, not a single mod in here to ban Hardboiled. Yes, Rocket Bunny, nice. You the other day you were asking about what do I use besides Blender, and now you figured out Blender. Good job, man. Good job. raining here. Got rain. So good. We need more rain. I like you. Of course I like you. Don't tell his girlfriend. Salad Dogs, mod me. I will keep up this chat tradition and ban Hardboiled for 3 seconds. I don't like it when Hardboiled gets banned. Does everybody else like it when Hardboiled gets banned? Are Hardboiled and I are the only ones that don't like it? Yeah, speed lines. Yep. Yeah, I know what you mean by speed lines. I'm going to try it without speed lines at first, though. Because speed lines are really easy to add later if the animation needs it. Let's rotate these little. Do you like the running joke? Hardboiled likes it. Oh. Don't let Salad Dogs do it. He didn't earn it. It's true. I know. If I let Salad Dogs be a mod all of a sudden, that means that I would be alienating the other people that have been asking. So there's kind of a no more mods for a moment section of today. It's like an era of the stream where there can't be too many more mods because there's already so many mods. But Hardboiled is the mod of Steam, the only mod on Steam, too. Got frame 2, 3. Rotate. Let's say it hits the ground right there. And then the next frame it'll bounce. And I'll have to redraw these so they're 3D. So the light hits them correctly. And then this will hit the ground right there. Because this thing doesn't have a shadow, it should look right. But this thing needs to rotate more. Maybe hit the ground like about like that. Oh, Pedro is? Oh, I thought you were the only one. Oh, cause Pedro asked right when you asked, huh? Oh man, sorry, I denied you the honor of being the only Steam mod. I didn't even think about the implications, man. My bad. Yeah, so this frame, these are going to bounce up. Actually, no, no, no. Before we make them bounce up, let's draw them correctly in this frame. Name the rocks Crocs. Right, yeah. Oh, my bad, my bad. Doop 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 boop beep doop 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 boop boop. That's pretty good. That's more 3D. Okay, next frame. Here's where they bounce. Here's where they settle. Wait, name the rocks Dwayne. Nice one. Nice. Dwayne, perfect name. Not Johnson, just Dwayne. Okay, I want to see him rotate. I guess they kind of do. Yeah, let's try this out. See what this looks like. In the game. Render, render, render. Rock zero foes. Wait, did I put this in foes before? Common. Whoops. Foes, Rock Zero. Data weapons, foes, Rock Zero. Yeah, okay. You found out about a game called Strafe? Yeah, I heard about Strafe last year. Yeah, totally right. procedurally generated Doom-like, and it's like super gory and bloody. I have until 2017 to keep you entertained. Done, man. I hope Songbringer entertains you, especially when it's finished. I think it'll be a lot better when it's finished. Right now, it's lacking in some departments, like the bosses and enemies and stuff. See if this works. Wake up before release. What's up, Alien? Hello, man. Yo, it's been a while. Hope you've been good, man. Yeah, look, they're dropping in, falling into pieces. Oh, but they're Z orders. All wrong. I guess it does need a health component then, so it can. Dropping them in exactly the same place. How is he doing that? Dude, move around a little bit. Quit dropping your rocks in the exact same place, dude. There we go. Okay, gotta figure out how to get this Z to be right. Zero health, and the zero health trigger does this stuff to blah 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 blah. You know what I'm saying? I know, right? What's up, Chaotic? Isn't there a check for stop resting? No, there's not. The only way it sets its Z order is when it dies, when an entity dies. Because otherwise, you know, most entities. Man, my ears like wants to pop. Most entities like need their Z to stay normal. You know what I mean? Even if an entity is at rest, it's stopped. Its Z order needs to say the same. It's only when an entity dies, really, that. Oh, yeah. Okay. We'll just give it a hit point. Health, HP, 1, or like whatever, a quarter. And then. I guess we'll go remove, and I think that should remove. We might need to go category foe. I don't know. We'll see if this works. I think this will set its Z order. Oh, see, it just deleted it completely. So it's not supposed to delete it unless the AI system for behavior remove. No. Your remove. Set a break point. Pizza's getting cold. Just out of curiosity, in the middle of a game development, how do you earn money? Rock Bunny, there's a lot of ways to do that. Probably one of the best ways you could do to make money as you're developing your game is to gear up for that the whole time. Make sure your whole plan is to do a Kickstarter or some kind of crowdfunding. So yeah, Patreon's a great way to do it without doing a Kickstarter. Probably Patreon is the easiest way to start, right? But Kickstarter is really a kick-ass way to first of all make money during your game's development. Second of all, you're validating the fact that people will buy your game. So if you don't do a Kickstarter, you're running the risk of failing really hard at the very end of your game. You could spend years making your video game. If you haven't verified that people will buy it, that people will actually spend money on it, then you run a huge risk. So I honestly think running a Kickstarter is one of the best things you can do for your game as early as possible in your game's development too. Sell your liver. The other way you can make money is through alpha funding. You can alpha fund your game, and that means you're just selling pre-orders of your game, basically, during your alpha period or your beta period. And alpha funding is also another way to do it. And you can look up both those terms, alpha funding, crowdfunding. And also you can check out my article I wrote on it if you want. Gama Sutra. Nathaniel Weiss's blog, here it is. I think. Yeah, The Cure for Indie Game Failure. This is my article on how to make money for your game. I think you should read it. Green light? Green light's not really a way to make money. It is a great way to get yourself on Steam, but. Yeah, there you go, Hardboiled. Yeah. Okay, so this rock should be exploding at this point. This should be a rock. Identity ID 1151, profile, nothing. Should be, oh no, profile rock, good. Okay, so we got a rock. What's this have? It should have. Yeah, we're changing health. It's not invincible. It's not dormant. What's its hit points before? One? Okay. We're not applying elements. New hit points should be zero. All right, good. We got zero hit points. Activate change HP, no. Store HP, no. Healed, no. Hurt, yes, but this is not what we want to check. We want to check on death. Here we go. Changer, what's changer? Yeah, chaotic. Yeah, I hope it's useful. I hope it's useful. It's really what I was trying to say there. I say a lot more in that article, and hopefully that'll help a lot more than just me trying to rant in a couple sentences. I think it might be here in this death animation. Animated true. Play sound. Set animation. It's even calling the said Z order. Oh, but it's setting it really low. Oh, this might be the problem. Yeah, let's figure that out. Wait, what's it? Is it removing again? Oh, it might be removing twice. Well, that would make sense. Oh, it's cure. What's my view on free-to-plays? I don't have a very healthy view on free-to-plays. I can't, I mean, if you're asking for my clear opinion on them, I hate them. I hate free-to-play games, and I hate the way that they are they're devaluing video games, I think. And the type of – they usually – like only a certain type of person plays free-to-play games, and I don't think they're their most, like, nice people to developers. And most of all, I failed really hard when I wrote a free-to-play game. My buddy and I spent 2 years of our lives. I spent nearly $20,000 of my own money, like just funding my own development for that video game. I spent $5,000 of my own money on marketing and then released this free-to-play game and made $0. Absolute, like to this day, the game makes about $20 a month. And we deserved way better. The game we wrote was really good, I thought, you know, and especially we spent so long on it and it turned out to be a really good game. And then we just make no money because basically it's a free game and everyone can play it for free. And we didn't put in all the things that a typical free-to-play company would do, you know, like I forget the names of those companies, but if they had control of our game, they probably would have put all these cheesy things in the game to make money on the free-to-play thing. So, like I said, my opinion on free-to-play games is I don't think they're a very good thing to make at all. But, you know what I mean? And there's a big thing to be said, too, for the difference between free-to-play games on mobile and free-to-play games on Steam. That's a totally different thing. So I was primarily talking about free-to-play mobile games. So, you know what I mean? Free-to-play Steam is a lot different, you know. And some of these games are succeeding really, really well and making more money than they would have if they would have sold it normally. So I don't know, man. I just have a bad attitude about it. The game we wrote is called Hero Bash. It's on iOS. Oh, yeah. It's calling this, like, every frame. Oh, I think I see what's going on. When it calls, when it removes. I think it needs activate. zero HP, and then the collision system. When it does its zero HP, it needs to make sure and remove an AI component if it has it. Okay, so let's try this. The rock will have we need a collision flags. Activate zero HP. Hardboiled, I don't like them either, but there are a few really good free to game. Yeah. Alien Swarm. Yeah. Yeah. Relic Hunter Zero, cool. Right, yeah, free to play on mobile. Hi, if you play one level a day, but you pay $6, you can play as many as you want. Oh, see, now it's hitting it because it's not deleting itself every single frame, I think. If I go over this. Oh, yeah, now it's got a Z. All right, good, good. Oh, and it's removing itself twice, so it doesn't need to do animate release anymore. It doesn't even need to really do... Hell, it just needs to do nothing but spawn small explosion and remove. I think bad FTP game is Peter Panic. Let you play all levels for free, but you need to buy the ability to save your game? Wow, that's interesting. Let's talk about something different. Yeah, totally. Vlambeer is an awesome company. And great people at that company, too. Rami Ismail. Really look up to that guy. He's awesome. Good. All right, now we got these rocks exploding, and they have a proper Z order afterwards. And they should have... Yeah, they look good. What is going on? All of a sudden my computer sounds like it's about to take off. It's warming up its engines. It's about to... About to hit the ring. Oh, it's game show. Game show is just killing it. Game show. This is the new version of game show, of course. It's just eating too much CPU. It says it's not. Man. Okay. Ignore the fan sound coming out of my computer. Oh, definitely some variety. Yeah, we need some more of these. Definitely. Does he actually follow me on Twitter? I know he checked out my article when I wrote it. That was cool. The only microtransactions I like is when it's customizable stuff. That way you can support the developer if you want. It's not required to play the game. Yeah, exactly. That's how we designed Hero Bash. We wanted to make it so it was cool microtransactions. But it didn't work financially. There's not enough people that will actually support developers. People, from what I understand, free to play, you literally have to use the crappy techniques. Unless maybe on Steam it's different. I don't know. I guess once again I'm talking about mobile. Oh, and see, Zilton hates it. Personally, I just prefer to play for game or pay for games. You know, let's pay for a game, get all the content it has, and not worry about microtransactions. Okay, let's do a smaller sized rock. Or become as big as League of Legends, right? Addicts, whale, right? Whales. I know. That's weird. We were thinking, and oh God, all these terms, man. Oh, I hate all these terms. Remind it basically all these terms in the concept of free to play reminds me of my biggest failure in indie game development. So sorry, it's just bringing up all these crazy feelings for me. So there, we got a little smaller rock. And when it explodes into pieces, we'll also make the pieces smaller. Wait a second, wait a second. How small did I make that? Fourteen by 13. I think we got another package. One sec, guys. Back to the fan, man. The fan noise. Game show freaking 2.0 sucks. Upgrade to 2.0 and it starts the fan. I'm talking about a game where it is free and all of my microtransactions is customizable stuff. I think the game's price affects how people view the game too. Yeah, that's true. If your game is free or cheap, then your users are less likely to place much value in your work. I know, it's painful to realize that, you know? Especially when you spend years making your game. Yeah, dismissiveness, angry demands. Oh, I know. Isn't worth it for most developers, save for a handful of indies who really have it figured out. Yes, I agree. If I don't know how to figure out free to play, but if you're doing it right, good for you. And of course, larger companies can really easily figure it out because they and their larger companies are totally more willing to use those more insidious techniques and stuff. Flappy Bird, right? But why did the developer take it down? It was dark in here. I just didn't realize it was dark before. Arcane. Oh, that's exactly 75%. All right, great. 75% it is. Oh, I should just make this whole thing 75% smaller. I'm just gonna make a smaller version like that, yeah. So easier, way easier. Image size, 75%. And let's make it a little different how these pieces land. DLC quest. He took it down because he couldn't handle the money and fame. And death threat? Really? You got death threats? I know, right? Songbringer. It's coming out, man. I promise. I promise. Okay, so now we got a second, slightly smaller rock. Rock one. The 5 to 25 price point is ideal for most. Yeah. Yeah, right. It's not so cheap that people will devalue your work, but not expensive that people won't consider it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree, Saldongs. Totally. Just be lazy like you only know how to. When's the next beta? It's going to be next Wednesday. Next Wednesday-ish. This week, I would love to get one out like right now, but we have a big weekend coming up. So I'm not even going to be streaming tomorrow. I'm not going to be streaming the next. I'm not even going to be streaming until next freaking Tuesday because we have a weekend plans, and then on Monday I'm going to GDC for the day. I'm not really going into the GDC conference or whatever. I'm just going over there. And then, so yeah, next stream is going to be Tuesday. But yeah, Tuesday we'll be streaming. Wednesday I'll be working on the update, getting it out. So Wednesday, Thursday of like next week will be the next update. Yay, pizza. Yeah, sorry about that. Yep, stream. It's all, what can I do? What can I do? Can't stream while you're on a weekend trip. Now, since there's two rocks now, we should be able to put in this star thing. Finally, a break from your face. Looks like we broke it. All right. So we didn't like that. Animation Rock Star Zero has no frames. All right, all right. So it looks like I'm not going to be able to get that that finished during today's stream because we're out of time already. This is 2 hours into it. So the next step I'm going to work on, though, is to get it so there are multiple different rocks falling from the ceiling. And then the last thing I'll do is make it so that the multiple rocks appear in different places. So why is this build failing all of a sudden? Let's just run it. Well, no, it's not going to work either. What the hell? Oh. Saudans, the creator from Catacomb Kids is apparently giving a speech on human fragility in games. Whoa. Nice, right on. Pedro, what's up, man? Sorry, just shutting it down right now. Okay, so yeah, my next steps in this whole rocks falling from the ceiling thing is going to be making it so there's multiple different kinds of rocks. And then I'm going to make it so it's random. Right now, it's actually spawning the rock really close to the boss. And I want to make it random, so it's just like all over the screen there can be rocks and maybe multiple of them at once. Like just... And it's going to happen when he lifts up his hammer, goes raw, and then the rocks fall. So that's the goal for tonight. Yeah, so that's it for today's stream. Sorry about that, but once again, the next stream is going to be Tuesday because of this weekend plan stuff and GDC next week. So hope you all have a good night, and thanks for watching, and we'll catch you guys next time. Oh, Boogie's here too? Boogie! Boogie's not here. I'll see you guys.